The sands of Tatooine await you, apprentice. I've gleaned much since our interrogation of the Republic agent here on Dromund Kaas. I am certain Nomon Kaar brought this gifted Padawan to Tatooine to train with a legendary master named Yonlok. Years ago, I urged the Dark Council to hunt down and destroy this Jedi. They refused, and Yonlok went into hiding on Tatooine.
What should I do with him once I track him down?
Yonlok is the one who brought the Padawan's powers into expression. Now they share a special bond. Find him and destroy him.
What do you hope to achieve by doing this?
Nomon Kaar shelters his prize, so we will draw her out by destroying everything she loves. My servant Sharok Biv will guide you. She's eccentric, an acquired taste. But give her the benefit of the doubt.
As you decree, my lord.
That is all.
The harsh sands of Tatooine welcome you. I am Sharok Reeve. Our Lord and Master Darth Barriss bid me to impart my knowledge of this planet and help you track down the Jedi Master Yonlok.
It's a pleasure to make your acquaintance.
I will be your compass. You will find Master Yonlok by tracing the path the Padawan and her master took. I can tell you where they started. I followed them to the forbidden lair of the ancient sand demon, a terrible beast. The Padawan left her weapons and entered alone. Impossibly, she returned unscathed.
Now you've got my undivided attention.
The Sand Demon is the fiercest creature on this planet. You don't just walk into its lair and return without a scratch. I investigated further. The beast was there, also undamaged. And what's most perplexing, its skin was glistening.
That is very confusing. Was it bleeding?
Not blood as from a wound. More like the layer of living gel one is born into the world covered in. What happened in that cave is a mystery, as is where the Padawan and her master went afterwards. There is one man on Tatooine who might be able to explain. Isabo Jeef. He's as old as the sand. Part madman, part soothsayer.
I want to talk with this man immediately.
It will not be easy to speak with Jeef. The small farming settlement where he lives has been overrun by Exchange thugs. The Exchange hates the Empire for running them out of Mos Eila. They will allow me to pass, but they'll attack you on sight.
I see no problem here.
Then I will meet you at Isabo Jeef's hut.
Is weeping, and the tears evaporate in the heat of our sins.
I think you mean from the heat of our sons, Isabo.
No, child. There is a dark presence newly arrived on Tatooine.
Ah, Sith. You made it. The hostiles outside were no match for you, I see.
They tried to stop me. They failed.
Failure can be contagious, and hard to dispel once contracted. You are the Seeker Sharok spoke of. You wish to understand the Jedi's purpose in the lair of the Sand Demon.
You see it correctly.
My eyes may be aged and failing, but my mind sees.
Please, Isabo, make haste. Tell my friend what you know. I will remain here after to hear your wisdom.
Fine. Gather close. Few are aware that Tatooine was once a place of positive force energy. Jedi made pilgrimages here to renew and purify. The sands speak of a ritual called the Demon's Blood. This is likely what the Jedi that Sharok witnessed was engaged in.
Explain this ritual.
The Demon's Blood. A Jedi seeking enlightenment would cover himself in fresh sand demon blood and enter the village of the Savage Ones. Cowering before the Demon Slayer, the savage ones would reveal the path to self-discovery and to that which the Slayer seeks.
Do you mean the Sand People?
Tatooine makes most who come here savage. And the Sand People have been here all along.
Isabeau, as I told you, the girl faced the beast but left it unwounded.
There must be another way to bathe in the beast's blood. But you'll have to discover that for yourself, if you care to. To know where this Jedi girl went, you'll have to perform the ritual yourself, and then see if the savage ones speak.
I appreciate your help and insights.
Step lightly on my desert. It has been through so much in its life.
Here are the coordinates you will need. After you face the Sand Demon, I will meet you at the Sand People compound. If the legend is true, and the Sand People have something to offer you, I wish to see it with my own eyes.
Don't have a good feeling about this.
I'll make you feel better later.
We're about to face a monster that can swallow us whole. I'm thinking, if the Jedi perform the demon blood ritual without a fight, there must be a way we can too. As a favor to me, could we please get through this without mixing it up with the Sand Demon?
I was already planning on doing that.
Oh good. That's a relief. Except it's showtime. The monster's caught a whiff of us. I'm ready to back you up.
Desert monster, I stand my ground. I will not run.
Look into my eyes, beast. I show my back to demonstrate my dominance. The beast sleeps. Now, let us see what transpires.
Great. Gross. This thing went to sleep and shed its skin. It's oozing blood and nastiness all over the place. And the smell. Oh, Cag, we're gonna stink for days. What if it never wears off?
It will be all right, Vet.
I sure hope you're right. I take a lot of pride in my hygiene. So, let's get out of the stink pit, huh?
You took the words out of my mouth.
Lead the way. I trailed and observed your descent here. I could not believe my eyes. The Sand People all ran from you. What transpired inside the Sand Demon Cave that makes this so?
I mastered the demon without lifting a finger, and it shed its skin.
Remarkable. And you have bathed in the demon's essence. The Jedi Padawan must have done the same. Now, Isabeau said that this is where your path will be illuminated. There doesn't seem to be anything here. Wait! On your guard, Offworlder. One of the Sand People approaches.
I will respond in kind.
I've never seen one of the Sand People approach an outsider in peace. This parchment the Sand Person brought is remarkable. It is a crude but very clear map of the desert. It marks a door carved into the wall of the Desert Wound Ravine. But I've mapped this ravine and there is no such door.
If this is where the Padawan went, I must follow.
I shudder to think what awaits you there. The ravine marks the farthest I or anyone I know of has dared venture. Here are the coordinates. I will follow stealthed, using the dune's shadows.
Think first of your own safety, and do not follow if it becomes too harrowing.
Your concern is appreciated. Darth Barriss enlisted my services to be scout and lookout, and I intend to do my job. Head deeper into the desert, and you will find the Desert Wound Ravine. Safe journey.
Either a mirage, or a trap set by a nasty underwater monster. Or both.
Take a good, long look, Lightweight. See the man you're supposed to be. I'm the embodiment of your true potential. I am what you could be if you had the guts to follow the dark path more faithfully. I knew I was good looking, but this is ridiculous. Vanity becomes you. But your looks will do you no good unless you heed my words. Cease your merciful tendencies and embrace the full meaning of the dark side of the Force, or you will be destroyed. Exactly how will I be destroyed? There are any number of disasters you are flirting with. You are Sith. You walk among Sith. The stench of the light in you will be like rot in their nostrils. Darth Barriss will smell it on you and will strike you down without mercy. He has yet to notice anything. Do you really think he would tip his hand to you? See, that is where the light will truly fail you. The light blinds you to the ill will growing from your fellows. Barriss and the other Sith will have the advantage of deception. And the power of the strongest forces in the galaxy. Passion, rage, love. The light shuns and denies these things. Tell me more of this. Now you're coming around. Think this through. This Padawan Barriss wants you to kill can destroy him. He has seen it. What if you can seduce her? Claim this Padawan for yourself. Corrupt her to the dark. Control her and add her power to yours. A master of the dark side could turn this Padawan, and then you can destroy Barriss and claim everything he has. I'm not convinced. Fool, one day the darkness that you reject will overwhelm you. Strong and viable. With this victory, our essence has been purified. In the clarity of this communion, a vision of our destiny on Tatooine appears. Can you see it too? An encampment hidden in the farthest reaches of the desert, past a rock formation called the Forbidden Pass. Tell me more of this. There is no doubt this is where the Padawan went. This is where the Great Master helped her powers become expressed. The image fades. Find the Forbidden Pass and confront Master Yonlok beyond it. Our journey on this planet ends there. Farewell.
I cannot believe what I just witnessed. Did you just tell yourself to venture beyond the Forbidden Pass?
That is my understanding.
I am chilled to the bone. The desert beyond the Forbidden Pass is an area that no one can survive. No one! Even the Sand People dare not go. You mustn't go!
Your concern for me is unnecessary.
This is not some silly superstition. Those who go beyond the Forbidden Pass are never seen again. I will not. I cannot follow you there.
You've done enough, Shorik. Thank you.
That is kind of you to say. I told Lord Barriss I would see your mission through, but I never imagined it would come to this. With a heavy heart, I give you the location of the Forbidden Pass. I am ashamed that my cowardice paralyzes me. I fear I will never see you again.
I'll be fine. I don't plan on dying in this desert.
If you plan to cross the Forbidden Pass, that is exactly what you are doing.
Master Yanlok, the Sith you've been tracking is upon us. Retreat to safety. I will take the intruder on.
No, Yu Li. Control your feelings. Stand at my side. I will face this trespasser. Come no farther, Sith. I have been aware of your pilgrimage here. You are a fascinating and contradictory example of your order. I know why you've come. Master Nomen Kar's Padawan threatens you somehow. You seek to flush her into the open and silence her.
You've figured it out.
I will not allow it. It won't be the cause of her exposure. She came to me for guidance, and the bond we struck was the most profound of my life. We are psychically linked, she and I, and I have already warned her about you. She will not fall for your manipulations.
I assure you, I can be very convincing.
Your will may be great, but hers is greater, and mine is unrelenting. The disparity in our capabilities is equal to the disparity in our age. You cannot win. Turn away now.
I fear no one.
This is not an attempt at intimidation, just a simple statement of fact. In me you face a full Jedi Master, and Yu Li has greater command of lightsaber combat than any Jedi Knight I've trained.
color me nervous. Have we ever faced a full-fledged card-carrying Jedi Master before?
The Jedi have no idea how lethal you are, Vett.
I sense that's a bluff, but no matter. Your compatriot's query is moot, as you will be facing us on your own.
Well done, Master Yanlok. Now please, retreat and let me face the Sith.
Your concern is appreciated, Yu Li, but I did not seize the advantage here to immediately relinquish it.
You don't fight fair, Jedi.
When the stakes are this high, I am bound to do whatever it takes to preserve the order. Now for the last time, will you stand down?
I don't respond well to threats.
Enough of this! It's useless to reason with the Sith.
Yu Li, don't! Blazes, my hand is forced!
Hold your weapon, Sith. I beg you.
Yu Li, stay your tongue.
No, she is just a Padawan. You are a great master. I must bargain for your life. Sith, I'll tell you everything I know, if you spare Master Yanlok.
Don't you want me to spare you, too?
My life is less important. You may do with me as you please. Her name is Jaysa Wilson. And Nomen Kar has taken her to...
Yu Li, you have no recollection of the Padawan this Sith seeks.
I have no recollection of the Padawan this Sith seeks.
Now, sleep. I do not relish wiping Yu Li's mind like that, but his feelings for me got the better of him.
Don't apologize for doing what's necessary.
It's a terrible thing, a last resort. I had to act for the greater good. Jaysa is special, her power unprecedented. If untouched by the likes of you, she has the potential to lead the Jedi to greatness.
I'm I'm going to do much more than touch her.
You know Jace's name, but that is all you'll get here. So you may as well kill me. I must find tranquility, so Jace will sense only peace when you strike me down.
I'll grant you that allowance. Just tell me when you're ready.
You are a surprise, Sith. But if you think allowing me to find peace will make Jace susceptible to you, you are mistaken. There is no death. There is the Force. I am ready now.
Be at peace, Master Jedi.
Thank you.
Well, the rumors are true. Being paralyzed is a blast. You put on quite a show. I knew you were good, but,
Hope you enjoyed yourself.
Not at all. It was infuriating not being able to wipe the sweat dripping from my nose. So, Sharik said she'd be at the ship. She thought we were done for. Can't wait to see the look on her face.
She will be surprised to see us.
I'll practice my smug look on the way there.
I never expected to see you again. Does this mean you ventured beyond the Forbidden Pass and found Master Yonlok?
The mission is complete.
This is a great lesson. The only barriers that exist are the ones we create in our minds. I will never again assume that I know all there is to know, and I will explore the entirety of the Tatooine Desert without reservation.
Be sure to take care.
I will strike a balance between care and daring. I hope Lord Barriss knows how fortunate he is to have such a fine champion shepherding his cause. I shall never forget you.
I'll remember you fondly as well.
Safe travels, my lord. If you're ever on Tatooine again, come and see me.
Ugh. I hope we never come back to the sandy inferno. It's bad for my complexion.
If we never return here, I won't miss it.
Glad we're on the same page.
Admirably, Apprentice. Your time on Tatooine was well spent. Nomen Kaar's Padawan Jace Wilson no longer enjoys anonymity. I am very pleased.
I'm touched by your enthusiasm.
Your handling of Master Yonlok has sent our enemies a clear message. Nomen Kaar and Jace Wilson now know they cannot hide. It gnaws at the Master, and will bring his prized Padawan to her knees.
I cannot wait to get my hands on them.
I believe that moment is rushing toward us. Only Alderaan remains. Jace Wilson's homeworld. Go there immediately. I will contact you when you arrive. Apprentice, I see you've touched down on Alderaan, Jace Wilson's home planet where Nomen Kaar found her. Excellent. You will discover everything you can about this Padawan and destroy everyone she loves there.
It is a certainty.
I hope your results will confirm your confidence. Unfortunately, with the civil war for the Alderaanian throne raging, your contact, Duke Kendo of House Thule, has become unreliable. Kendo was supposed to find Jace Wilson's family for you, but it seems he's distracted. You must undistract him.
I will handle it.
Kendo is a political creature. The consequences of failing me are abstract for him. Once they are made concrete, he'll cooperate. You'll find him in the House Thule Executive Chambers. Make haste.
Miss me?
You lack patience, Duke Kendo. There are standard procedures that must be adhered to.
Your disregard for our family rules is appalling. You are an abomination. Goodbye, cousin.
Fools. They won't be feeling much of anything for long.
Duke Kendo, Darth Barriss sent me.
What? You're not on my schedule. I don't appreciate being interrupted. Barriss isn't even on my radar, Sith. I have a war to wage and personal ambitions to achieve here.
Is breathing one of your personal ambitions?
A threat? You see these Sith I have attending me? Your corpse will be my message to your master. Femres, make this intruder a distant memory, will you?
I'm sorry, Duke Kendo. We are assigned to protect you and support your interests in the struggle for Alderaan. But we serve the Emperor first, and we will not cross Darth Barriss, or his apprentice.
It's good to know some people have respect.
We consider you an ally, friend.
Okay. That was unexpected. It seems I may have been hasty regarding your master's needs. How can I make amends?
Do your job and all will be well.
I pledge the same level of focus that had me so absorbed in my own work. I pledge myself to your directives, and as I aid you, perhaps you'll be moved to help me in mine.
I'd say there's a very good chance of that.
Then you can consider me extremely motivated. As I recall, Darth Barriss wanted information on a young Alderaanian girl who was taken off-planet to train with Jedi Master Nomen Kar. I was to locate her family so that you could, well, send the girl a message.
That is my understanding.
The truth is, information about this girl is difficult to come by. I managed only one lead. Nomen Kar's Padawan fits the description of the former handmaiden of a noblewoman in House Alder named Lady Renata. I've questioned her already, but Renata is protected by House Alder's greatest champion. The man has never met his match in melee.
He's never met me.
If I may, once you've eliminated her protector and gotten what you need, I would personally be very indebted if you'd arrange to have Lady Renata brought to us for questioning.
I'll take it under consideration.
All right. I just hope the mood strikes you. While House Alder is a small player on Alderaan, it is affiliated with House Organa. Therefore, Lady Renata's estate is in hostile territory and very well defended. Be cautious.
Be ready for my return.
I do hope to see you soon. Until then...
lady. We have intruder.
Lady Renata, I seek the family of your former handmaiden, Jaysa Wilson.
What's this nonsense you're spouting? I don't know what you're talking about.
Lady, let me kill this Sith like the last one Duke Kendo sent.
Windred, you don't need my permission to kill an enemy that comes barging through my door. Make it fast.
Let me save you the trouble.
This Sith faster than last one. Sorry.
This can't be. I'm sorry I ordered him to kill you, Sith. I hope you don't hold it against me. See, I've been fending off Duke Kendo's advances for some time. I just assumed you were here for him. If you're not working for the Duke, I'll gladly cooperate. You mentioned a girl, yes? Jaysa someone?
Jaysa Wilson. Kendo told me she used to be your handmaid.
Kendo is a liar. I was aware of the young handmaiden who left Alderaan with the Jedi Master. And I did hear the name Jaysa Wilson, but you're mistaken. I didn't know her. The girl never served me.
Do you know anything about her?
Duke Kendo can include that in his interrogations. The Duke congratulates you on your impressive venture into House Alday. I'm here to take the fair lady to him.
No! Don't let him take me to that pig! I do know who the girl worked for. I'll tell you all I can, if only you'll keep me from Duke Kendo.
Don't leave anything out.
All right. I'm going to trust that you'll be honorable. Before she left with the Jedi, Jaysa Wilson was the handmaiden of Giselle Organa of House Organa. They were inseparable. Before the war, Giselle was an aristocrat like myself. Now she leads the Organan troops against House Olgo.
Where exactly is this Giselle Organa?
Her headquarters are somewhere on the front line.
The Duke will know where to find Giselle Organa and how to reach her. If you let me deliver Lady Renata to him, I'm sure Kendo will happily shed light on the situation for you.
The lady isn't going anywhere.
Thank you. It's good to know some Sith have a sense of honor.
Fine. As I said, I will not oppose you, nor will I defy your decision here. I meant what I said. I'm sure Kendo can help you find and confront Giselle. You should consult with him on it.
I'll do just that.
I will update Kendo, so he is ready for you.
Despite the destruction you caused, I hold you in high esteem, Sith. I only hope you make that worm Kendo pay for misleading you. Take nothing he says at face value.
I appreciate your advice.
I'm sure you'll be fine. Goodbye.
I heard you decided not to allow Fimres to bring the Lady Renata to me. I am most disappointed.
You would have tired of her quickly.
Oh, it would have taken hours. Perhaps days. By denying my claim to Renata, you certainly aren't providing me much incentive to help you. Where's my motivation?
I suspect self-preservation is incentive enough. Or maybe I should just kill you.
Consider me motivated. So, Fimres tells me the lead was fruitful. Although Lady Renata was not the gold's mistress, she knew who was. Giselle Organa. I should say, General Giselle Organa. Now you have to track her down, which poses a bit of a problem.
Some elaboration is required.
Giselle Organa leads the Organa War against House Ulgo. Her headquarters is protected by an impenetrable force field. No firepower can breach it. The force field allows Giselle and her advisors to be stationed very close to the front and maintain a more hands-on command.
Sounds like General Giselle knows what she's doing.
As smart as she is, there must be a way to overcome... Wait. Yes. A force field needs power to maintain itself, yes? So, if we manage to cut the power... And I bet I know exactly where Giselle is getting her juice. If I'm right, you could just walk through the front door.
Sounds very promising.
Almost all the power on Alderaan is supplied by the planetary generator. Giselle must be piggybacking the system to power her force field. Several of my fellows do this to maintain their special security needs. A precise charge of the generator will force failsafes to fire. The planet won't miss a beat. But ancillary systems, like Giselle's force field, will have to be manually reset, which could take some time.
What do you think of this plan?
I'll tell you, I just don't trust this guy.
What a charming creature you are. Believe me, this is the only way to gain access to the Organa headquarters. Femres, fetch a 7-stroke-7 detonator from my arms cabinet there, and give it to our friend.
As you wish.
The Alderaan power generator is located above the Strait Valley, and it boasts the planet's most advanced security systems. You'll have to fight your way in, set the charge, then fight your way out before the boom. It won't be easy.
Consider me warned.
Once you've detonated the generator, you'll still have to wade through Giselle's surrounding army and invade her headquarters before her force field is reset. I'll be eagerly tracking your progress. Good luck.
Lead the way.
Our standing army outside is being wiped out. Someone or something is on its way here.
My technicians almost have the force field reset, but we're still a sitting duck.
There have been several assassinations of House Thule officials whose security systems were down by the generator explosion. In my opinion, House Ulgo is behind all this.
Your opinion is about to change. I'm here for information on Jason Wilson's family.
Intruder!
Giselle, get behind me.
None of you panic. I'll handle this. Sith, did I hear you right? You've perpetrated all this in search of my former handmaiden?
Tell me where her family is, now.
I admire your single-mindedness. You have decimated my forces outside. They were to be deployed to secure a part of my front that's about to fall. Now I have no reinforcements. You seek information only I have, and my front needs bolstering. Perhaps we can help each other.
I'll defend your front, but tell me what I wish to know first.
I am not so gullible. I'll tell you about Jason Wilson's parents. After my front is defended. Now, on my left flank, there's a tunnel between my forces and House Ulgo's that has been hard-pressed by the enemy. I have only a ragtag troop defending this tunnel, and Ulgo is about to attack. You must repel the enemy forces.
You'd better hold up your end of the deal.
I am a woman of my word. What's left of my forces at the tunnel choke point are being led by Lieutenant Dargus. I'll let Dargus know you're coming. He'll contact me as soon as you've succeeded. Assuming you do.
Your lack of faith is an insult, Giselle.
Believe me, I know you're my best chance. Goodbye, Sith. As uncomfortable as it is to say, I hope we speak again soon.
Man, this is it. With the captain dead, it falls on me to rally what's left of us. I guess the reinforcements aren't gonna make it. We'd better get ready. Ulgo forces are fast approaching. I can feel the tunnel walls shaking.
That's your knees knocking together, coward.
Lieutenant, we've been flanked.
No, wait. General Giselle sent word that a Sith would be coming to our aid, but I thought I must have misheard her.
Sir, I'm not trusting a Sith. No way.
We're drastically outnumbered, Sergeant. The General's given an order, and besides, without help, we die for sure.
The rest of the men and me aren't sticking around for a suicide run.
You'd only get in the way, anyway.
Follow me, men. Only a fool fights where there's no chance of victory.
I don't think so, Sarge. Maybe with the Sith at our side, we can repel the attack. Yeah, and I don't relish the idea of being a deserter anyway.
Glad to hear it, men. Sergeant, you are relieved, and I will report this to General Giselle personally.
Now you're sounding like a leader, Lieutenant.
Even though I understand the instinct to run, desertion can't be tolerated. Get out of here, Sergeant. Let the real soldiers fight the good fight.
Lieutenant, the Ulgo forces are coming now. What do we do?
Stand your ground and fight like men.
Take your positions. This is it.
Yeah.
That was amazing. They just kept coming and coming. And you, you're a war machine.
I appreciate your observation.
You might want to stop all the chatter. Those bozos are regrouping for another attack. Get ready.
Let them come. They'll find I'm more than their match.
Here they come.
Are superficial.
Hey, I just snuck a peek into the tunnel. There's a heap of those laser brains getting ready for another swipe.
Let's stay sharp.
Get ready to be overrun. Get General Giselle on the holo for you. She'll be very relieved.
What's the word, Dargus? I assume that since you're hailing me, the day is won?
Yes, General. The Sith single-handedly turned back the entire attack.
Sith, as painful as it has been, it seems you've come through. I hope you're not expecting a thank you.
I want what you promised.
Yes, well, a deal is a deal. Now, I promise to tell you where Jaysa Wilson's parents can be found. They have been servants in Castle O'Ghana for many years. Sif, the Wilsons are a simple, innocent, hard-working people. They deserve your mercy.
I'll take it under consideration.
That's all I can ask.
Goodbye, Sif. And
Thanks for saving my life.
And grab some shut-eye.
General Jessel's warning was true. The Sith has come for us.
Men, rally around me. The fight is upon us.
I didn't think a single assailant could make it through Castle Organa's defenses all the way here to us.
I kill everything that gets in my way.
Mark my words. I will stop you, Sith. You will not harm Parvin and Gregor Wilson. I vow it.
I disavow it.
Please. If we really are the cause of all this death, I want to know why.
Fine. Say your piece, Sith. I'm not going anywhere. And I will protect them, no matter what.
It's going to be fun acquainting you with reality.
Please, no more bloodshed. If there's something you want from us, I'm willing to listen.
Gregor, this has to do with Jaysa. I just know it.
Yes, I'm here because of your daughter.
I knew she shouldn't have gone with the Jedi. Now the Empire is hunting her. Sith, Jaysa was our life. She was going to marry Organa nobility so that we would no longer have to be servants.
When she left, we sacrificed that dream. We don't know anything about Jaysa now. We were told we would probably never see her again. We are mere servants. What could you want with us?
I'm here to deliver you from servitude.
You want to help us?
No, Gregor. The Sith is toying with us before killing us.
Heed your wife's warning, Gregor Wilson. Sith are devious and demented.
Is that what you mean, Sith? By killing us, you end our life of servitude? Can't you spare us?
If you align with the Empire, you live.
What do you mean by this? What is to happen to us if we do as you say?
You'll be Imperial servants instead of Organan servants.
Dirty, no good Cretan!
Parvin, Jaysa has gone off to a life of discipline and detachment. We are unlikely to ever see her again. The Sith is offering us a way out of this, a way to live.
Jaysa is sensitive, Gregor. She will feel our betrayal. It will fester in her. Don't you see? This Sith is banking on that.
Do you want to live or not? Don't you think she'll feel it more severely if I kill you?
My wife can't see the big picture. You offer a choice between death we're pledging ourselves to our daughter's enemy. I choose that Parvin and I live in the arms of the Empire, and I trust that my daughter will understand and remain strong.
A wise approach.
Please, my sweet, stand with me on this.
My place is with you, Gregor. As long as we're alive, there's hope.
We're in agreement. We shall embrace the Empire. Tell us what happens next.
You'll receive instructions at the Imperial landing.
I'm so glad you've all found an accord. But there's still the matter of you being our enemy, Sith. Not only will I not allow the Wilsons to do this, but you had yourself a killing spree getting here. That can't go unpunished.
Stand in my way, and everyone dies.
Yes, Master Volrider. Stay true to the Jedi Code and keep the peace. Too many have died already today.
Gregor and I go of our own free will and spare this house any further pain.
This doesn't sit right. But I can't attack someone walking in peace. Even a Sith.
You just saved your life.
The code is everything, Sith. But I wouldn't expect you to respect it. Leave out the back door to avoid further casualties. I'll say nothing further.
Apprentice, the Sith Fenris who attends Jukendo was able to patch me through to you directly. Excellent. I am seeking an update. News of your search for Jaysa Wilson's family has reached me, and I am quite concerned.
What news have you heard, my lord?
Jukendo contacted me to tell me that you have been busying yourself with personal exploits and disregarding my mission.
You believed him? He's a fool.
I know to take him with a grain of salt, but you've been there for some time. Tell me you found the family of Noman Kar's Padawan. Tell me they have been taken care of.
Yes, Master. The situation has been handled.
Then all is well. Good. No doubt the Padawan is twisting with grief. You eclipse my greatest hopes for you and prove you belong at my side. Which makes my susceptibility to Duke Kendo's gossip about you all the more foolish.
You said it. I didn't.
I have learned to follow all roads to their conclusion. So when I hear something alarming, I always pursue it. First off, Kendo said that you set an explosion that caused the death of several Thule dignitaries.
I'll kill that worm.
I assume then that wasn't the case. Shouldn't surprise me. Kendo also said that you helped the Republic defend their front in Organa's war against House Ungo, painting you as a traitor.
You know I'm no traitor.
It would surprise me to discover such a thing, but I cannot assume anything for certain. All that matters to me is that your mission is complete. For whatever reason, the man has taken it upon himself to slander you. I have no further use for Duke Kendo. Punish him however you please. If it were me, he'd pay severely.
I'm interested to hear what he has to say for himself.
Do what you will, but quickly. Until we destroy the threat of Jaysa Wilson, nothing else is important. Goodbye, apprentice.
Come in. I heard of your success, and I'm so very pleased for you.
You told Barriss I murdered your rivals, and you called me a traitor.
Oh, I see. How awkward for me. Allow me to explain. I realized when you blew up the power generator, several of my rivals would be exposed, so I seized the opportunity to eliminate them. I had company when I was speaking with your master, and I needed to keep my fellow house members blind to my maneuvering.
That is a lie. You contacted Barriss yourself, alone.
The truth comes out.
I only wanted Barriss to know that I was looking out for him. It was harmless. I knew you would succeed, and all Barriss would care about was that. Please, please don't kill me. Fimres, you and your men are assigned to me. If I am attacked, you must defend.
If Darth Barriss's apprentice decides you die, we will not intercede.
No one dies today, but he must leave Alderaan forever.
And give up everything I've worked so hard for?
The alternative is death. Your choice.
No, it is a most gracious allowance. I will leave this planet, my home, immediately. A broken man.
Oh, you're breaking my heart.
I know there is no sympathy for me. Goodbye, Sith. I shall never return to this place.
What a sad, pathetic man. Serving him was a daily dose of nausea.
Consider yourselves set free.
Now we report back to our master on the Council. We will be paying attention to your exploits. Farewell.
Crushed Alderaan under your boot, Apprentice. I am incredibly impressed. The planet will feel the sting for years to come.
I am your humble servant, Master.
Noman Kar's Padawan can no longer hide in anonymity. I am pleased. By rooting out this Jaysa Wilson's parents, you have reached across the galaxy to strike a sharp blow at our enemies. Every lead followed perfectly. Every planet ravaged. Our adversary is growing antsy. I can feel it. Expect news soon. Barriss out.
My lord, I thought it prudent not to interrupt Darth Barriss. We received a recorded transmission. It is queued when you are ready.
Sith, I'm Jaysa Wilson. My master, Noman Kar, has no idea I'm sending this message. Let's be real. We both know this isn't about us.
Ah. The hunted seeks the hunter.
Our masters pretend otherwise, but this is personal. You and I are only pawns in their private war, and those I care about are caught in the middle. It has to stop.
Wow. Gotta give it to her. She sure got guts.
She certainly does.
I sense inconsistency in your actions. Maybe you're as tired of all this passive-aggressive foolishness as I am. This message includes coordinates where I'll be waiting in my ship. Let's discuss this face-to-face. No more nonsense.
What do you think of that, Captain?
It could be a trap, my lord. Noman Kar may have put her up to it.
Hey, don't listen to Captain Paranoid here. I don't think it's a trap. I trust her.
I'll take that under advisement.
The coordinates are set, my lord. We can rendezvous with her ship whenever you give the word.
You are fit for duty. Return to your post.
Well, well. We're going to have to thank Noman Kar after all. The Sith showed.
Stand down, Sith. The Padawan you seek is not here. Master Kar discovered her plan and talked her out of it.
It's not your day. You were expecting one lowly little Padawan to crush. And instead, you get us.
You'll do just fine. I enjoy destroying your kind.
Then we have something in common.
I'm Alden. This is Xylix. We are fully trained Jedi Knights and more than your match. You should submit.
Of course, we have yet to encounter a Sith who had the sense to surrender. You all seem bent on having us destroy you.
Surrender to me, and I'll end your suffering quickly.
See? Just like all the others.
It seems you're right, Xylux. Prepare yourself. Noman Carr warned that this Sith is especially brutal.
For once, I agree with Noman Carr.
We'll be sure to let him know you approved. Futile to oppose you. You won the day, Sith, so kill me if you must.
Inform Carr I will not be denied. He and his Padawan will fall to me.
Your mercy is unexpected. I'll convey the message.
The timing of this call is fortuitous. I was just about to contact you with news.
The Padawan bade me meet with her, so I went to end this. But two of Carr's Jedi friends were waiting instead.
Fascinating. It seems both Master and Padawan have been disturbed by your exploits. I have received a transmission from Noman Carr, calling me out, if you will, challenging me to face him to the death. Our enemy has become desperate.
He must have lost his mind.
Your efforts to disrupt his precious Padawan have unnerved him. He seeks to turn the tides. Carr fails to understand I have outgrown our personal dispute. He expects me to jump at the chance of strangling him. He will be unprepared for you.
Just tell me where to go.
The duel is to happen on Hutta, at the site of Noman Carr's betrayal so long ago. A fitting place for this to end. Defeat him, but do not kill him. His torment will reach out to his Padawan. He will be the bait that brings her to you.
I hope you're right about this.
I can feel Jason Wilson on the verge of breaking, and Carr's desperate actions confirm it. Subdue the Master, and the pupil will come to save him. I have foreseen it.
Presence tells me that my fellows Alden and Xylux must have failed. Pity. Should have known Barriss couldn't be trusted. As a man of my word, I'm here, alone as agreed. Your master shows himself a coward, sending you in his stead.
He sends me to do all his killing.
You're young in the Force, a mere apprentice. I'm a full Jedi master.
What's your point?
Brawl is bravado. Your master's actions expose the flaws of the dark side, and your flaws for following him. You are Barriss's pawn, an especially resourceful and powerful one, but still only that,
I must put an end to you. Once you're out of the way, Jason will provide the proof I need to open the Jedi Council's eyes and expose Barriss's network of spies.
Don't force me to destroy you.
This ends now, Sith.
Sent us in case you needed help. Clearly that's not the case. He said Nomen Kaa should be kept alive. May we stabilize him?
No. Barriss be damned! I want to die. Then Jason will be safe.
Despite what you think, I'm not trying to kill your Padawan.
Lies. Tricks.
We'll save him, my lord, and then be out of your way in an adjacent chamber. Hurry, man! The Jedi's fading!
I'm alive. I see through you, Sith. You only saved me so that Jason would believe your heart is pure. I will not be the bait that draws Jason to you.
It gives me such pleasure to hear your despair.
Not laugh at my expense, Sith. You and your master are nothing. Jaysa is beyond your reach. She will still expose the truth. So keep me alive. Yeah, I want to be around when you fall.
Hey, looky, looky. Jaysa showed up.
Make room for our guest of honor.
Sith, I have come. It seems I was expected. Your men outside let me pass. Release Master Kaa. Your efforts to draw me out have been a success.
Jaysa, no! I told you to stay put. How dare you defy me?
I have long been waiting for this moment.
My sacrifice for nothing! Stupid child, for all your power, you have understood nothing.
What have you done to him, Sith? Has this been inside him all along? No, it can't be. No one can hide such darkness. Somehow you've turned him mad.
I only exposed what was lurking inside.
Is that what you call what you've been doing? I am confused by you, Sith. Your actions with my parents on Alderaan and Master Yanlok on Tatooine paint different pictures. To show such mercy with one, but cruelty with the other. You are an enigma. And when I felt my master slipping toward death, you saved him. Who are you?
I thought you could sense the true nature of any being.
Use your power, Jason. Look into the Sith's heart and you will see.
Look at me as long as you like. I have nothing to hide.
Very well, then. I see mercy and fairness and even perhaps compassion. You have walked the light path. This is not what I expected. Your treatment of my people has been chaotic. You're Sith. You embody darkness. How can you be light?
Nothing is black and white. Everything is unknowable.
So, although you reflect the light, it does not determine your future actions? Then I will never know where I stand with you. You leave me no choice but to engage.
Yes, strike now, Jaysa. Take the Sith down.
Defend yourself, Sith! Match. You had the opening you needed to kill me, and yet you held back.
Your death would be a tragedy.
Your actions reflect only light. You appear to be an agent of the dark side, but it's a mask. But Master Carr also wears a mask, and his deception is a much uglier one.
It's not his fault. His connection to the Force is flawed.
All my life, I've put up with deceit and denial. I thought the Jedi would be different. You've shown me otherwise. You've exposed Master Carr for what he is. It's your power that reveals a person's true nature. Your conviction and purity bring a reckoning that cannot be denied. I want that.
Join me. And from within the Sith Empire, we can forge a lasting peace.
Yes, I see the advantage of this. So much more can be achieved from within. At last, I feel a sense of purpose, something I can count on. What do you wish of me? And what shall we do with Master Carr?
He has turned away from the light. He needs guidance to heal and find his way back.
Your wisdom is unrivaled, my lord.
Jaysa, I'll see to it that the Jedi disavow you. You will be labeled an enemy of the Order.
Then I'll finally know where I stand with you. You took me as far as you were able. I hope this does not leave you bitter.
With the Council's help, perhaps he will come to understand.
I wish him the best. I am ready to learn your ways, my lord. And I look forward to aiding you any way I am able.
No. No. This cannot be. My fate. Who are you to preside over me? You are nothing. I am Noman Carr.
All right. Back to Sith business.
Apprentice, my soldiers informed me that you subdued Master Carr, but I've heard no further update. What has transpired? Where is Noman Carr?
What became of him is inconsequential.
I suppose that's true. It was the girl who posed the threat. I see you have a new passenger. Jason Wilson, I presume.
This is my master, Darth Barriss.
Greetings, my lord.
Your parents are alive and thriving here on Dromund Kaas. They'll be so pleased to know you are safe.
Please tell them I have never been happier.
I sense her devotion to you, apprentice. However did you manage that?
I can be very persuasive.
Marvelous, apprentice. Simply marvelous. There's no denying you are a master of the dark arts now. Only the most accomplished among us are named as lords among Sith. You have more than earned the distinction. I hereby confer the title of Sith Lord upon you.
You honor me.
Through your exemplary service, you honor yourself. I award a considerable stipend to those who attain such a rank in my service. Enjoy it. Now celebrate as you see fit. Then return to me here on Dromund Kaas. I have great plans for us.
Wow. A lord. I'm impressed.
Congratulations, my lord.
You've both been a great help.
Service is its own reward.
Yeah. What he said. I already prepared Jace's quarters. I'll go ahead and show her to them.
Nice of you to assume some initiative.
I'm here to help. Come on, Jace. Let's get you set up.
Whenever you need me, my lord, whatever your order, I'll be ready.
As it should be.
So, my lord, now you have the girl. A victory, I dare say, even Barriss failed to anticipate. I'm a bit perplexed. Your methods have been rather unorthodox to this point.
We will be the catalyst that ushers in a new paradigm for the galaxy.
I am open-minded and ready for the evolution, my lord. I leave you to enjoy this achievement.